Shalom, beautiful children of Adonai. Today I'm going to talk about the Shalom of Adonai. Hallelujah. I'm going to start by reading Philippians, verse 7 through 9, chapter 4. Then God's Shalom, passing all understanding, will keep your heart and mind safe in union with Messiah Yeshua. In conclusion, brothers, focus your thoughts on what is true, noble, righteous, pure, lovable, or admirable. On some virtue or on something praiseworthy. Keep doing what you have learned and received from me. What you have heard and seen me doing. Then the God who gives shalom will be with you. Human beings were not created to endure anxiety, to worry about bills, our children, our health, cares of this world. We were created to enter into God's rest. We were created to praise Yahweh when we keep our mind. Hallelujah! Shut. Focused on the Holy One of Israel, you will have perfect peace. But only when we keep our minds focused on Adonai will we be in perfect peace. Hallelujah. Yahweh said, I am giving you my peace. My shalom. Enter into the shalom of Adonai. You're not to withdraw understanding. In all your ways, acknowledge him, and he will direct your paths. Kohelet, chapter 8, 14 through 17, is a profound scripture because it answers the questions that many ask. Why do good things happen to wicked people? And why do bad things happen to good people? So I'm going to share this scripture with you today. There is something frustrating that occurs on earth, namely that there are righteous people to whom things happen as if they were doing wicked deeds. And again, there are wicked people to whom things happen as if they were doing righteous deeds. I say that this too is pointless. Why is it pointless? It's pointless because no man, hallelujah, can grasp, hallelujah, the understanding of the mind of our Creator. Hallelujah! If we try to understand the things of Yahweh that are not for us to be contemplating on, that we are incapable of understanding in our human brain, it will lead to utter frustration. That's why Solomon, in the book of Ecclesiastes, said, it is pointless. It will lead to utter frustration, and it will lead to anxiety. You will not have the shalom. Hallelujah. I will continue to read. So I recommend enjoyment. A person can do nothing better under the sun than eat, drink, and enjoy himself. Hallelujah. This is what should accompany him as he does work for as long as God gives him to live under the sun. When I applied myself to gain wisdom and to observe how people occupy themselves on earth, that people's eyes don't see sleep neither by day nor night, then, on looking over all God's work, I realized wisdom. Solomon, a man of wisdom. Hallelujah. I realized it is impossible, hallelujah, to grasp all the activities taking place under the sun, because even if a person works hard at searching it out, he won't grasp it. And even if a wise person thinks he knows it, he still will not be able to grasp it. Why? Because we are creation. We are the creation of Yahweh, Hashem, the Holy One of Israel. Even the angels can't comprehend the mind of our Creator. We're lower than the angels. Hallelujah. How can we comprehend the mind of Adonai? It is written, as the heavens are higher than the earth, so my way is higher than your ways, and my thoughts higher than your thoughts. Hallelujah! Lean not to what you understand. You will never understand why good things happen to wicked people, and why bad things happen to good people. I'll tell you a story. My mom, she died on the Shabbat, April the 16th, 2001. I never met anyone more holy than my mother. She walked with God. She taught me about the Holy One of Israel, God, since I was a child. Hallelujah. Glory. But yet this beautiful woman of God, she developed metastatic breast cancer in 2008, and she never complained. This remarkable woman, she would go to chemo, get her chemo, and she would encourage the other patients. She would encourage the nurses. She would even wash out the microwave. Hallelujah! My mother had the gift of love. My mother was a giver, never a taker. Hallelujah! I would take her to the market after she came from chemo. She wanted to go to the market. I said, okay, Ma, I'd rather me do the grocery shopping for you. But she still wanted to feel, to keep busy. So I would take her to the market. You know what she would do? She would put the bags in herself. I said, Ma, you just came from chemo. And her face would drop. And then I realized she still had the spirit of giving and help. And I didn't want to take that from her. Hallelujah. But did I ever ask the Holy One of Israel, why did you take my beloved mother, 72 years old, who had chemo once a week for 4 years? Hallelujah. When there are wicked people in this earth that live well into their 80s and 90s and are healthy and strong, never even entered my mind. Do you know why? Because I trust Adonai. I worship Adonai. I know He is perfect and His ways are perfect. Hallelujah. So when my mother, when we gave my mother her going home celebration, that's what we call it. We don't call it a funeral. We worship, not worship, we celebrate her life. And we celebrate that she has gone to heaven to be with Adonai. Relatives that knew me in my past, they saw me at my father's funeral while I was very distraught, tearful. Hallelujah. But I've grown spiritually since then. At my mom's funeral, I'm praising Adonai. I'm lifting my hands, glorifying Adonai. Praising Adonai that He took my mother out of this body of suffering and brought her home. Hallelujah. I'm human. Sometimes I grieve my mom. But then Adonai, He reminded me. What did your mother always talk about? She always talked about looking into the eyes of Yeshua. She always wanted to look into the eyes of her Messiah. It is written, the pure in heart shall see God. No one had a pure heart than my mother. And Adonai, He let me know, Rakha Kadash, He's looking into my eyes. Day and night, he's looking into my eyes. And that gave me great peace. Hallelujah. And help me with my mourning. Hallelujah. So I no longer grieve being absent from my mother in the body. Sometimes I do, again, I'm human. But whenever I do, I remember what Rakha Kadosh told me. She's looking into the eyes of Yeshua. Day and night. And that's all she ever talked about since I was 17. Hallelujah. Glory to God. I want to close out by reading Isaiah Ishuyahu 23:3-4. A person whose desire rests on you, you preserve in perfect peace because he trusts in you. Trust in Adonai forever, because in Yah Adonai is our rock. He is the rock of ages. Hallelujah. Trust in Adonai. Lean not towards your own understanding. Life is a vapor. Don't try to figure out things that we're not meant to understand. Hallelujah. Our lives are in the hands of God. Our fate is in the hands of God. Trust God, and you will enter into his shalom. God bless you, beautiful children of Adonai.